Welcome to this week's episode of Azentuary. We left off last time with the team hiding in a bush.
For the usual. Alright,
so. You were hiding from the city guard. You were hanging out behind this bush because Castros had decided to make it his bed for the night and then kind of pulled you guys in when they were running around looking for you.
See, isn't it nice that I occasionally separate from the party?
If you say so. All right. What? So.
The only reason you guys are fine is because... Oh, whatever. Never mind. No, you go ahead.
It's always got to...
Dissing me?
It's all... No. No, not at all. It's always got to be about you, though, Castros.
Whatever.
Did we lose the guards? Are they still looking for us, or do they see us?
They're looking for you. They did not see you, no.
All right, okay.
Granted, they're not looking particularly hard. They're just kind of looking.
Okay. All right. How far away is the bush from the tavern?
Oh, let's say you made it. A couple hundred feet is all. It's not very far.
So I'm thinking we gather up Castros and see if we can't sneak down some side streets to start way to the castle.
Sure. Let's see. Let's have everyone do... We'll do a cumulative stealth check. So, let's have everyone roll for stealth.
No!
Well, it'll be as a party, so...
You're asking a dwarf to roll for stealth.
Yes.
Ray got 21.
Holy crap.
Ray's dexterous.
Mm. Yeah.
That'll be kind of fun.
I think Dane rolled a 2.
What?
What? Dane.
I told you, you don't ask a dwarf to do stealth.
I had a plan. Oh. Still kind of a plan. Sorry.
What's your plan?
I realized I wasn't talking there. Alpha got only got 20.
Only 20. Okay. I have a spell. Hey,
with all the buffs I have to my dex stuff, that's actually a pretty low roll.
Yeah.
I have a spell that I've never used because I have it. It's only a first level spell, but I can cast in a higher spell slot. It's Thunder Wave. If you guys remember, had it. So it's like a radius thing. If I want to, I could run into the group of people and cast Thunder Waves.
Let's try sneaking away first.
Well, it seems like you failed, so...
Well, cumulative. So if the rest of the group rolls well, then we might be all right.
I just need Castros' roll.
Yeah, I know. 16.
So let's see.
I'm just imagining Alpha running around Looney Tunes style, just pretending to be statues every time someone looks at him.
I mean, if Ray really wanted to, she could hide in plain sight, which is literally just me hiding in a bush, but it's effective. We're already in a bush.
So, cumulatively, you guys ended up exactly 1 point below where my dice check was, which is pretty funny.
Gosh darn it, Dave.
I don't find that funny.
You're the one bringing our class average down. Yeah. We gotta raise our average.
So as a group, you guys start moving, and everyone's being super silent until you go to make a move, like, across an area, and, like, middle of the lighted area, the guards are all have their backs to you. Dane just, like, drops something really loud, like, his shield slips and drags along the ground. It's just like, and they all turn and look at you.
Okay.
Can I just have Alpha grab Dane, put him on his shoulders, and start taking off through the city?
Does Dane resist, or would he resist?
If the soldiers start running towards us, then no.
Well, they're going to start moving towards you because they're going to be like, hey, halt!
So, do you resist, Dane?
No.
Well, he said no, so we'll do a quick, just to check, do a quick strength check. I want to see what you get.
Oh, 11.
You're going to have a little bit of trouble. You're not going to be moving at full speed. You can, like, lift and kind of pull him, and you're not, I mean...
Yes, he is pretty heavily armored, so it kind of makes sense.
Yeah.
Alpha's not the strongest, he's just really fast.
Yeah, but even at, you know, less than full speed, he's still probably about as fast as the rest of the party, so...
Well, my base move speed is 85, so if I dash to run, that would be 170, so less than full speed is still pretty quick.
Exactly.
Yeah, but
so,
I don't want you to, like, twist Dane's ankle or something.
I just have this...
I'm trying to, like, lug him onto his shoulders like he did with, was it Kasros before, running through the forest?
Yeah.
A fireman's carry. You got me in a fireman's carry?
There you Basically. Go. Yeah. So he was going to do a real simple, like, lift and ended up having to roll you, so you're just like,
ooh. Yeah.
This is what you get, Dane, for bringing down our average. Okay. So, Rain, I've
been left. Of course, you gotta realize that the average had to have been pretty high anyway, because what did you get, 21?
Yeah.
20? 16? I mean, the average is above 10 anyway, so I think it's just, our DM's unnerved dice.
You're still the one who broke around.
That's the real issue here.
I didn't roll against that. I just said a cumulative dice check of 60 with four people. That should have, you guys should have cleared it, and you hit 59.
Because of you.
you keep asking for dex rolls from the dwarf.
Yeah, get better dex. Yeah.
There are such a thing as dwarven rogues.
Exactly.
Yes, but that's not Dane.
Dane
is strength and, you know, intelligence.
Yeah.
Not strength and charisma.
Yeah.
Actually, I've been doing pretty good lately.
Lately. How many orcs have we had to pry open lately, Dane?
Remember. I've opened a couple.
So, 2d8, 4d8, 5d8, 6d8, 7d8. Kasros talking about us being left for dead. I don't have to be left for dead. I got hide in plain sight. I can literally just jump into the forest and I'll be good.
In any case, all right, so wait, hold on. All right, so Alpha grabs Dane, you guys all go kind of running down the area, and let's say that because of the stealth rolls that you guys got previously, the only one that's kind of left behind is actually Kasros in this situation, because Ray was at 21, Alpha's at 20, so they're able to kind of go to the shadows and, you know, evade pretty well, but Kasros' robes occasionally catch the light and reflect it to where they're able to pursue. Now, you guys are able to make it through the streets, generally evading. Can you what?
I wanted to try doing a radius attack while my party member...
You can stop. You could just stop and they keep moving.
Yeah.
What'd you ask?
How much damage do you think I should do? 78 or 8d8? I could technically do 9d8 as well, but I'd rather
just do 78. I mean, we're not necessarily trying to kill them. You just want to slow them down a little bit.
Yes, and if they fail a constitution save, they all get knocked back as well. Let's see. Can I do that? Can I just stop and, like, find my way in, like, the middle of this group of guards chasing us and cast this?
Sure, you could just, like, be like, wait a sec, and just stop, and the rest of them keep going, and then as soon as the guards, like, get close, you just step out and go, hi! Basically, like, pull an alpha.
Sure.
Hello.
Probably catch them off guard a little bit. How many of them are there?
Let's see. In this group, let's roll for how many are actually keeping up with you.
I thought there's like 20 originally, right?
Well, yes. Yeah, so let's say there's at this point, there's about 13 left that have been able to kind of catch up.
Cool. Would you say they're all within, like, a 15-foot cube of me, or can I, like, move that most of them are?
Well, not initially, but if you do the hello and stand there for a minute, they'll all kind of catch up and surround you.
Perfect. Let's do that. Okay.
All right, well, they catch up and surround you.
Perfect. All right, let's cast Thunder Wave in a 6th-level spell slot. Let's see how this goes. Okay, to cast is... Let me do math. 13, I think? I don't know if it's a... to hit. It's just... It's a radius thing.
Yeah, I think it just happens, if I remember right. And then there's... Let me find it really quick. I will look it up. Thunder Wave. 15-foot cube originating from you. Everyone just has to make a constitution saving throw, and on a failed save, creature takes thunder damage and push 10 feet away. Okay, so I have to roll... 13 saves. I'm gonna roll like my spell DC 16.
So
okay, it's a Constitution save. So fail. Oh, critically fail. save. Fail. So. 6 in, it's half of them, and 5 failed, 1 saved. Let's just double that for the rest. So 10 fails, 2 saves. So go ahead and roll me damage.
Pretty well, it's 40.
30, you said? I couldn't hear you.
40 thunder damage.
Oh, 40 thunder damage? Okay, so they're all dead.
Well, I stopped them.
Yeah,
so much for the Alpha trying to be non-lethal earlier. Jeez.
Yeah, so you blast them 10 feet backwards and their brains are liquefied. The other two take enough damage that they go down. They get knocked unconscious. They're not knocked back, but they're knocked out.
All right.
So, well, yes, the guards are down.
Good job. All right. I go running back after my party.
Right on.
78 might be a bit too much damage.
Yeah, I'm going to say that they could probably hear that.
Yeah, it's supposed to... I forgot what it says. I'm sorry. I have it written down. It causes, like, a 300-foot audible boom.
Yeah, they definitely heard that, and you guys react to the sound.
Well, yes,
the Alpha just says, "Oh my!"
Answer that.
Ray probably noticed that Castros is gone, and is just like, "Ah, again." I got them off our back, and the backups will probably be preoccupied cleaning, scraping the streets clean, so you're welcome. Hey, if they mess with me first, I'm not afraid to go non-lethal.
Okay, so does that mean you guys stopped and then Castro's caught up?
Ray's not stopping for Castro. She's gonna keep running.
Dane doesn't have any control over what's going on. Does Alpha stop?
Yes. Because he just says, oh my. Shocked by the sound. T was the one who just recently tried being non-lethal. And that sounds like, to him, being a very large explosion, which sounds very much on the lethal side.
I don't see what you mean. Alright.
So Alpha stops, Ray keeps going, gets pretty far ahead. And you guys hear from behind you the direction that Castros is coming from. A bunch of bells start going off, just being rung vigorously, you know, like handbells.
Okay.
Basically, like, alarms going off across the city. You start hearing the rings everywhere. It starts in that area, and then it builds and rolls around you, goes down as all of the different, like, night watch start hearing the bells and ringing them themselves. Now the entirety of the guard is on high alert everywhere in the city.
Nah, that's not a problem.
If it makes you guys less angry at me, they'll probably be after me rather than you.
We're not angry. Where are you trying to find us now, Castros?
Yeah. I stopped.
Alright, so Alpha stopped. Castros
we're angry, is... we're just disappointed.
I mean, I don't know what you guys expected.
I don't know. Dane's kind of fine with all of it.
You want to go with the, let's run away from them and hope we find a magic corner where they won't look.
No, that's not it at all. Anyway, so...
When do we rather run than fight?
Anyway, do you find us?
You want me to roll for that, Mr. DM?
I don't think so. You can just find them. I mean, you're going the same direction. I'd imagine that with Alpha stopping, he's pretty easy to spot. I mean, you've got a construct holding up a dwarf.
Okay, fine. Perfect. All right, so Castros finds us. Dane asks, what was that?
A lightning of our problem. Let's go.
What? No, just... did you do that, Castros?
Who's to say who does or does not something? Maybe it was just fate, you know? Like, maybe fate says that we all must do
Castros, did you do something to throw off our pursuit?
Yes.
What did you do?
May or may not have used a 6th level spell slot to completely annihilate most of the guards chasing us.
Castros, just tell me what you did.
I did! That's a good enough answer. 10 of them are dead, okay? What do you want?
I just want a straight answer, that's all.
Thunder. 6th level spell slot. Boom. There's your answer.
Okay. Well, yeah, well done. It's a good diversion.
Sure is, yeah, you're right. All right.
Let's find Rey and hold together in a group close to the palace, then she can cast Pass Without a Trace again.
Never cast it in...
Yeah, Ray, you're pretty far up ahead right now. Are you still being sneaky or just kind of bolting?
Nah, I'll be sneaky. I'll hide in the treetops.
Awesome. There's not really any treetops to hide in, but you can use the city. You know, you can basically use the buildings for cover and all the various stored things around them.
All right, so Rey is sneaking, and we're trying to find Rey.
Yes, I want to get I want to get a new stealth check from Rey.
Okay. 12.
Ooh.
Yeah.
With all of the din of alarm going off around you, and everyone on high alert, you go around the corner and accidentally come face to face with one of the searching guards.
Cool. I'm a book it the other direction, and can I have the book? All
right.
And on. Let me check out the exact things behind this.
Well, okay. Well, go ahead and do that. He does get, since you're turning and booking it, he does get a opportunity attack.
Okay.
So I just need to see what this is. Here it is. Okay. I am not rolling that. I mean, he's rolling with disadvantage. Oh, damn it. Really? That's disadvantage.
Okay. Would you roll a 20 and an 18?
Close. Yeah. Alright, well, he was shocked for just a sec. You take a run back, and he is one of them that was walking around with a halberd. So he gives it a drop and catches you with it in the side for... Let's see. No. Okay. 14 damage.
Well, at least the DM's trying to be nice. Dice just don't want to comply.
That's true.
Then I was wanting to do when I'm working. Dice worked out anyways. Dice picked my okay.
Yeah. Alright, so you book it away. He is now in pursuit.
Okay, cool. I'm gonna turn around and shoot at this guy in the head.
Okay, so you're just like, you dash away for a sec and then quick turn and take a shot?
Yep.
Alright, go for it.
17.
That hits.
Yes! Alrighty. Random arrow, because why not?
Why not?
40 or 58.
Alright, hold on. 40 is... the scrying arrow. Oh, this is the one that allows you to see where it ever it's shot. And 58 is the arrow of teleportation.
So, I'm gonna go with the arrow.
You go with the what?
The scrying arrow. I don't want to get teleported to anywhere.
Okay, well, in that case, so your non-dominant eye loses sight a second before you shoot, you fire, it hits him in the head, and you get to witness the tip of the arrow passing basically into his eye and through brain matter before popping out the backside, and you can see behind him.
Ain't that fun. Well, I'm gonna shoot again.
Okay.
Wouldn't he already be dead?
He's not quite dead. He's just got an arrow in him.
23.
Oh, that hits.
Let's see what we got. 95 or 38.
All right. 95 is spoil arrow. On hit, you have a horrible taste in your mouth that distracts you from whatever else you were doing. And, what was it? You said 30?
38.
38 is stalker arrow. Upon impact, the arrow lodges a small magical tracker in the target. You will know its location for the next 24 hours.
That one.
That one?
Yeah, I don't want a bad taste in my mouth that distracts
me. No, not your mouth, the target's mouth. So the guard would get a bad taste in his mouth and he would desire water immediately.
Okay, yeah, then that one.
Alright, so let's just say, because you already hit him in the eye, you hit that and then he starts vomiting and just goes down, you know, super damaged, two arrows, vomiting, the whole works. You've not killed him, but he's down. He's not going anywhere.
Nice. I'm gonna find a place to hide now.
Okay. Well, you definitely get advantage on that.
Okay.
Because he's not seeing you.
Okay.
Alright. So the others come looking.
23 for my hiding.
Oh, you're good. The others are looking for you. Are you looking for them at all?
Yeah, I'll keep an eye out for them.
Okay. So... you guys, let's redo your stealth checks as you are now trying to make your way to where Ray is.
Am I still being carried? Or is Alpha?
It's kind of up to you whether or not. I mean, we kind of cleared everything out, so maybe we're trying to be stealthy again. Alpha only got 17 on that one, so... a little bit sidetracked right now.
I'm going to assume that you put me down because, you know, carrying me is kind of a hindrance to you.
Yeah, we should come up with a mechanic for that.
So, Dane's going to try and roll stealth. Well, that's better. He got a 13 that time.
Nice.
I didn't roll as good. I got 12.
Okay. Well, you guys together aren't, you mean, you're not the most stealthy. You know, you're like going down, and as you're going, you're like, doo doo, doo doo. Do 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 do, and then someone, probably Alpha, is like, "Guys, should we not be quiet?" but because of your lack of particular stealth on this, you are easily spotted by Ray.
Nice.
Oh, fantastic! What does she do?
I'm gonna drag them all into an alleyway, and I'm like, "Can you guys not be stealthy for 5 seconds?" Or not stealthy? Can you guys? Yeah. I don't know what I was going to say there.
Can you guys be stealthy for like 5 seconds?
They were so horrible at being stealthy, I lost the ability to talk.
That's awesome.
Anyways, I'm going to groan and be like, alrighty, let's cast Pass Without a Trace and get us over to that castle.
Alright. Do your roll, make sure it doesn't fail.
13.
Yeah, it doesn't fail.
Yay! All right. You're passing without a trace all the way to the palace.
All right. Cool. So you guys are in a group. I'm assuming you're walking together. Because don't you have to stay pretty close to Ray?
Yes.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right. And if I remember right, pass without a trace is just like a massive bonus to the ability to sneak. All right.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I have, like, what, like a plus 10 on dexterity checks?
I think it's 15.
Let me check. Plus 10 bonus to stealth checks.
Yep.
And can't be tracked except by magical means. Awesome. All right. Well, you guys make your way up, and you get closer and closer to the palace, and then give me a perception check.
Passive perception or regular perception?
Well, regular perception. If it's passive, I mean, yeah.
You got a nat 20.
Oh, okay. Never mind. Everyone, just we'll go off of this. You poke everyone. You're like, guys, look up there, and you point up near the gate, basically the main gate going into the castle, and you see a dark figure that is surveying the area, and he looks. Like, all the guards are kind of giving him a wide berth. Like, they're almost afraid of him.
That seems suspicious.
And where was this?
It's above the main gate. Yeah, at the main gate, kind of up the road from you. And he looks like he's looking kind of down. You know, the palace is up above you, so you have to climb up the causeway to get there. And he's, like, looking down, observing the area.
Okay, is he, like, on top of the wall above the gate, or is he in front
of
the
main? No, he's just kind of at the gate, like, in front of the main gate, like he walked out the gate and is standing there kind of directing the guards.
Got it.
All right, well, we will try to edge closer and make out this guy's identity. I'm assuming it's probably the vizier, but I don't know.
How close are you going to try to edge in?
I don't know, close enough to try and make out his features.
Okay,
I would say, you know, what? 30 feet away still?
Okay. As you get not even, you're like, okay, we're going to go up, we're going to get within 30 feet, we're going to see what this guy looks like. You don't even get that close. You get within maybe, let's say, 60 feet or so, and all of a sudden a hand raises and he points at you, directly at you. The guards all look around. They can't see you, and he says something, some kind of a curse to them. They start running down and looking. They're like a couple feet from you, looking back and forth. They can't actually see you. And he gets angrier and angrier at them until he...
Mask Owen Dane.
Oh, he... From behind him, a group of rats come running down and run up onto your leg and body. And at that point, the guards see you.
Great. Crafty. Well, no time like the present for shooting some people. Ray's gonna pull back and shoot the closest guard.
I mean, I've already committed murder today. What's a couple more?
Yeah, we're for it now. Should we roll for initiative then?
Yes, please do.
Never roll for initiative. Happens very rarely. I got a 6.
Ray got a 24.
Ah! All right,
24, Castro 6.
That's okay, you know what? It takes me a long time to figure out what I even want to do anyways.
I have many options.
I rolled a 2 again for the second time tonight.
You still have your birthday nat 20?
Yes, he does, but I wouldn't use it on initiative.
And remember also, you add your dex to your initiative roll.
Yeah, I got a plus 0 on dex. Remember, dwarf. All my bonuses are strength and intelligence.
Alpha's initiative is 23 then.
23, geez.
All about all right. That dex.
Two high rollers? I technically got an 8 in dex.
Alright, sorry, this is not how I at all thought this was going to go down, so I'm trying to rapidly adjust everything.
Take your time.
7:15. Yeah, you guys definitely caught me off guard, despite the guards here.
Ha ha ha.
Well, like I said, I didn't know what was going to happen.
Start murdering people?
Alright, yeah, I also didn't expect you to go through murdering people.
That should be the first thing you expect of us.
Well, we've been pretty much trying to do workarounds lately, so...
Yeah.
Not so bad of being murder hobos. Unless they're, of course, you know, deserving of it, but that rarely happens, generally.
Generally. But our hand kind of got forced here, so, you know.
Guards that I can remember, they didn't have families. They were all zombies. They had no will of their own. It's better if they died. Yes.
Anyway. All right, so what's going to happen, Ben?
All right, so you guys have 5 guards directly in front of you. You are in a tight group. I'm just going to assume Dane's at the head. Alpha's kind of off to the right of him. The Astros is to the left of him. And Ray is at the back. The 5 guards are ahead of you, and the shadowy figure that was pointing is up in the castle gate. You also have rats on you, just so you know.
Friendly?
But well, it is Ray's...
You can probably talk to them.
It is Ray to start.
Again, you're like, me, I'm like, come, brothers, now is the time!
How many unions are gonna start?
Bro, I could. I should do that. Get the rats on my side.
Anyways, actually, is the wizard visible?
Yes, he is.
I'm putting my hunter's mark on him.
Okay.
That is a 12 to cast, which I think still works. It just doesn't have to fail.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, how does that one work? But if that's all it is, then sure, we're good.
Yeah. And then I'm going to shoot him.
Okay. I'm just curious. I want to look up hunter's mark real quick. Yeah, it's just there.
Yep.
Let me look again. You know, one of these days I'll take time to memorize.
Nope, anyways. That was a 14 to hit.
Amazingly, I think, yep, that hits.
Yeah, let's go. Alrighty. It is either going to be... Number 3 or 75?
3 is acid arrow, and 75 is bluff arrow, which is a regular arrow with an extremely persuasive letter tied to it.
I'm gonna go with acid arrow.
It's probably a better choice. Alright, so on this, the hit deals 1d4 acid damage in addition to your regular damage.
Cool. Oh. Actually, 12 damage.
Okay.
And do I have an extra attack? Or is it... I use the Hunter's Mark, so I...
Yeah, I think if you use the Hunter's Mark, that's your bonus action, because otherwise you do your second attack as a bonus action.
Yeah, fair enough. So I get my other attack still, or...?
No. Because you use Hunter's Mark, if I remember right, it's either two attacks or Hunter's Mark and an attack.
Okay, so yeah, that's my turn. Alrighty.
Cool. And then it goes to Alpha.
Right. How far away is this wizard guy from me?
Oh, he's going to be pretty far. Let's see. I mean, up the ramp, a good 80 feet.
Oh, that's within my move range.
I know it is. I realized that as soon as I said it.
All right. Alpha beelines to the wizard and just starts punching him.
Good.
Okay.
I still have key. I'll use the bit trying to knock out the guards, which apparently was pointless, but still have enough ki built up. Alpha is just going to Furia blows this guy into oblivion. How dare he sick rats on us and the guards?
Yeah, the guards ahead.
All right, first one is a 17.
Yes, that's going to hit.
All right, second one's a nat 20. Third hits. One's a 19. Fourth one is a 13.
Does not hit.
Fifth one was 7.
Also does
and
not hit.
The sixth one is 21.
That one hits.
So 3 regular hits and a nat 20.
Yeah, which for that one, just go ahead and do your double damage.
All right. So we'll do... Oh, okay. Well, the first hit, the second one was nat 20, so we'll roll them in order. So 23 plus...
And can you, real quick, tell me, do your fists count as magical attacks?
Yes. Well, they okay. In terms of resisting and calculating resistance, they do consider that. Like, they're physical, but if something's resistant to physical, then they count as magical.
Gotcha. Okay.
So the second punch, the critical was for 46. So we're at 69. How do I keep rolling 18? That's another 23. Okay. So that's 80, 92 plus.
I have it added up here. You can just tell me each one.
Oh, no. I'm doing the wrong counts. So never mind. Sorry. I was doing 20s instead of 8s. Never mind. No. It's all right, 8
well,
damage.
I pull that out.
So it's 8 damage, okay. 24 damage, 9 damage, and 7 damage. That's a lot more reasonable. Okay.
Yes, that is. That's much more reasonable. All right. So that's... All right. I guess you're good?
Yes. Should be.
All right, cool. The first guard is his turn. Let's see. He is closest to... Let's just say I better roll to see which one's the first guard. I'm just going to go across here. It's going to be that one. He's closest to Kasros. So he is going to attack Kasros. Let me find my guard. Here he is. And he rolls hit. Let's see. Wrong one. So, oh, that's only a 16 to hit.
Castros has a low armor class. That hits.
Oh, it does?
Yep.
Okay. Good to know.
I only have a 15 right. armor.
Oh. For some reason, I thought it was higher. All right. Well, he hits you with his longsword. And let's see. That is a... That is an 8. The 8. Oh, 16 slashing damage.
Oof.
Yep. And he can, let's see, he can hit that again. Comes in. Yep, that's an 18 to hit.
Yeah, that's
for 11 slashing damage. And he has the ability after two hits to push against you with his shield. This is labeled as a shield bash, but it's only a 10 to hit, so he goes to do that and somehow misses.
Cool.
Alright. Now, it is the turn of the mage up on the top. Alpha is standing in front of him. And... Let's see. What are we going to do? Ah, I know. Okay, so in front of you, Alex, or Alpha, you suddenly see kind of this ashen blank face that is somewhat behind the robe. Almost makes a smile, and then his body just explodes in size out of his robe as he doubles and grows. Like, two of his two arms turn into tentacles, as do the next ones down. His legs become large. He grows like three eye stalks out of the top of his head, and let's just say for fun, gives you a hissing scream like, the end of the second Pirates of the Caribbean movie. You know?
Oh my.
Maybe the T-Rex from Jurassic Park? Yeah, that might be cool. Yes. Is...
Oh my, indeed.
And I just need to check one thing real quick, if that's a... That's all he can do, and he's done. It's hard to tell. I'll give him... Let's say he can have one action as this, just because it's something that I'm not used to. It's a real weird one. All right, so he will swipe at you then with one of his arms, which is, of course, not on this sheet that I have right in front of me for some reason. All right. Oh, man. Like I said, I wasn't expecting this. All right. Roll, he's going to swipe at you, and that is a 26 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
I thought so. And that is... 16 bludgeoning. And I need you to make a... Dexterity save.
All right. The one thing he absolutely excels at. That's a 23.
Okay, cool. You're fine. I'm sorry. I did that wrong. Sorry, I'm reading the thing right now. That was supposed to be a strength save.
Oh.
I read the wrong paragraph.
20 then.
Okay, you're still fine, but I was a paragraph off of what I was supposed to be reading. Okay, so you're golden. All right, there's two more guards that come down, and we'll just use these next two to go after Dane, because he's there, and I'm just going across from left to right, so the next one is him. And the first guard is going to take a hit at you for 14 at the miss. And then 12 and misses. Good lord.
I think you've been rolling well enough. You can have a couple misses.
Yeah. Well, yes, but it's just kind of ridiculous. And I'm just going to run the both of the... And then he gets mad and he tries to throw himself at you with his shield. And, you know, just like body slam you with his shield. And that is a... Oh, that one's 23 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay, so that's only a... All right, so he slams into you for... that's 12 bludgeoning, and I just need you to make a strength save.
All right, one sec. Lord, I'm really tired of low rolling. That's a 14.
14. All right, he knocks you back and he falls on top of you as you go prone. The next guard, let's see, Alpha is up there. So the next one charges at Ray.
Yep.
All right. Try and control these guys. All right. Charges at Ray and takes the first swing, which is, 27 to hit.
Jesus.
Yeah. That hits. Just barely.
Ah, dang it. Well, all right. Maybe next time you'll escape. All right. That one is... 13 slashing.
Good God.
As he swings again. Oh, and misses. That was a 14 to hit.
Okay, cool. Actually, I'm going to use that then. What was the first damage?
The first what?
The first damage. What? How much was it?
14. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So since he missed, it was a melee attack, correct?
Yes.
That means I'm going to use my reaction to aim that attack at someone else.
Okay.
Or the nearest guard to him. Use that.
Okay. There's one kind of right behind him. So, all right. You redirect it back to that guy.
Yay. I love this new perk, man. It's the best.
All right. Well, then he... Let's see. Oh, yeah, he does 15 damage to that other guard. So, let's see. That's that one right there. He takes 15 damage. All right, and then the last thing he'll do is try to do his shield thing against you, which is a 20 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay, so he hits you, and that is... 11 bludgeoning, and I need you to make a strength save.
Okay. 17.
You're good.
Yeah.
Alright. Alright, that was that guard. Alright, the rats, which are running around still... about you guys and are on you. I'm going to say there's just one. Let's just say there's two of them. Let's make this easier. We'll say one of them's on Alpha and the other is on. Let's see. There's three of you down there. Let's go 2, 4, 6. Two is Kasparos has the other one. And so they will try to bite. And that is. So Alpha, the one tries to bite you, and that's a 20 to hit.
Nope.
Nope. All right. And the other one tries to bite Kasros. That is a 17 to hit.
How buffed are these rats?
I know, right?
Did you get hit?
Yes.
Okay, sorry. Well, that's so it bites into your neck or whatever, does 5 piercing damage.
Holy crap.
Jesus.
They're rodents of unusual size.
Random marshes.
All right, and then
when it means I'm getting hurt.
And then the guard that was redirected to be attacked by the other goes to attack Ray. Oh, Lord. Oh, you guys have me clicking back and forth between screens like insane. All right. That is 25 to hit.
Yeah, hits.
And
roll your d20s and make you roll with d12s only.
Yeah, I might have to start doing that. Which is 14 slashing damage. And then the next one is 18 to hit.
It's
okay, and that is 10 slashing damage. And he tries to shield bash and misses completely.
Cool, is that a melee attack?
Yes.
I'm gonna redirect it at his friend.
Awesome. Cool. Well, he does 14 bludgeoning damage to his friend.
Jeez.
And let's see what happens if he gets knocked prone or not. There's these guys' constitution. He gets, and he knocks his friend prone.
Somebody else deal with the prone one, because I have my eyes set on the wizard.
Well, unfortunately, I'm still on the ground buried underneath a stupid soldier.
All right, hold on. I gotta make notes on this, or I'm going to lose track of this. Okay, he's prone, and you're prone. Everyone else is still up. And it actually is Kasros.
Okay. So there's only 2 rats?
Yes, there's 1 on you and 1 on Alpha.
That's not worth starting a rat union then. Alright. Let's see. What kind of damage can we do today? Alright, And 10-foot cubes, arrange whatever formation you wish. That's a lot of fire damage. Probably shouldn't do that. I could. Shoot. Okay.
You could summon a couple creatures. We're a little outnumbered right now.
Are we?
Yeah, you are.
I know. All right. Let's see then. I have a lot of spells, okay? I've got many options. I can't up the... I don't think I can cast Conjure Animals in a higher spell slot. That would be too convenient.
I don't think that's how it works.
Oh, wait, I can!
Oh, you can?
Choose one of the summoning options above, and more creatures appear. Oh! Well, ain't that handy.
4 times. Oh my good lord. 3 times as many in a 7th level slot?
Hey, guess 4 what? Times. Level spell slot open.
Oh good lord.
Cool.
Alright.
We'll cast 2 challenge rating creatures, right?
You're casting 4 challenge rating 2? Or?
Yes, so 3 challenge rating 2 creatures.
Okay. 3 challenge rating 2. Let's see if I can find out what that's going to be. Try and limit the results here a little. Alright. You want to give me 1, 2, 3. Hold on. can't use those. You want to get roll 3d6 and tell me what each of the numbers is.
Pete Dalton. 1, 3, and 5.
You have a giant boar, a griffin, and... Well, that wasn't what I meant, but all right, why not? A Pegasus.
I've got a griffin and a Pegasus.
Yeah. Why not?
Airstrike. Let's see. Okay, should I roll initiatives for all of them then?
Yes, please.
Okay. Let's say the boar gets an 8, the griffin gets a 7. I'm not rolling great for their initiatives. And the Pegasus gets a 19.
Wow. Okay. Alright, well that's...
Oh, it's ready. It's like, I'm here to beat the crap out of somebody! Let me at him!
Okay. Well, was that your entire turn doing that summoning?
Actually, let me see. Sorry.
Pegasus motto, don't say nay to battle.
I might use my bonus action a wild shape.
Okay.
What would be most helpful? An owlbear? Challenge rating 3, or I could be my newly found roper, which is a challenge rating 5.
Yeah, but your roper can't really move, can it?
It has a speed of 20 feet. It can climb for 20 feet. No, 10 feet. No, speed of 10 feet, climb 10 feet. It's hard to read.
Yeah, it can move just slowly.
It's very slow. I could be a giant crocodile instead, but it's not much faster.
You could be your silver wormling.
Unless a lower challenge ring. It's only like... Yeah, it's only challenge rating 2 compared to the Roper and Giant Crocodile, which are both challenge rating 5. So the Roper and Giant Crocodile are on the same level as the Elementals.
Okay, well, whatever you want.
Let's see, which is strong? I think I'd rather be the Crocodile. Elicit fear into the hearts of others. Be a crocodile. Yeah, I'll use my bonus action to wild shape into a giant crocodile.
Alright, noted.
And that is how I will end my turn.
Awesome. And then it is Dane.
Dane! Let's see. It's a ranged attack. I just don't think that's going to work. The problem is, you know, Dane's on his back and someone's laying on top of him.
Well, you can easily roll off. If you just want to roll to knock the guy off, I'll just give you that as, like, and then... You know, use half your movement to roll and get up, basically.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay, so there's half your movement. You roll out, you get up.
Okay, is he still on the ground or is he up now too?
Nah, he's on the ground.
Okay. I'm going to swing my axe at him.
Okay, you get advantage.
Thank God, the way I'm rolling, I need it. Okay. Huh, Jesus. All right. That's a 17 to hit.
That, I believe, hits.
Oh, well, thank God. Okay, so with this axe, if I don't want to use the soul thing, what's the normal damage roll?
Just 1d12.
Perfect. Okay. Oh, okay, but it's also plus something, right? It's plus...
Yeah, your strength.
And then
and the proficiency.
Yeah, the plus two because of my dueling thing.
Yep.
Is it just proficiency? I mean,
no, my strength. Strength plus proficiency plus damage.
Oh, wow. Okay. So that is 18.
Okay. Because I'm pretty sure. I may be wrong, but...
It is.
It is without proficiency, I think. Sorry. I think it's just damage plus strength.
Okay, but still.
Plus I get the plus two dueling.
Yeah, so that's right. So it's damage plus dueling plus strength. That's what it is. I was incorrect.
Okay, so that's 11 slashing.
Okay.
Do I still get two more attacks, or does my movement kind of me roll?
No, your movement is separate from attacks. You still get your attacks.
Oh, perfect. Okay, I'm gonna hit at him again.
Okay.
Still get advantage on that?
Yes. Yeah, he's on the ground. You're just wailing on him.
All right, 15.
Does not hit.
I didn't think so. Rolling slowly worse and worse.
Oh.
Well, that one will work. 21.
Yeah, that hits.
And 14 damage.
All right.
And I think that's my turn.
Cool. All right. There's... Let me double check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so there's one guard left that rolled exceptionally bad. He must be the other one that's up next to you. So he sees you get up and is like, whoa, whoa, and takes a swing and misses completely. That's hilarious.
Oh, good.
And let's see. Try again. And that one. Oh, yep, that's a 22.
Yeah, it'll hit.
So that one is 11 slashing. And okay. He will try to do his charge against you, and that is a 17 to hit.
That does not hit.
All right, well, he misses. He goes to hit you with the shield and misses completely.
Well, thank goodness.
That's must because he got up and are moving around. And we're back to Ray.
Cool. Alrighty. Let's try to shoot this wizard again.
Okay, there is a prone guard immediately next to you and another guard immediately behind him.
Yeah, but I have my hunter's mark on the wizard.
Okay. Hunter's mark on the wizard it is.
You might want to use your soul arrow against the wizard because he's like a big bad now. Here, got it right now. One of your...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we can do Solero.
And do remember, the wizard is currently in the form of a large, scary creature that hit Alpha with a tentacle.
Twenty-eight to hit.
Yeah, that hits. Good lord.
Great. I have to figure out this new arrow now. There's a lot of details in those things. Yeah. Yep. How exactly does the soul arrow work? I'm looking at it and I'm like, how do I decipher this?
Alright, well hold on. Before I do that, let me paste you what you're shooting, just so you can see it. And then I will open up that. Where did I put it? Oh no, I lost the file.
I can read it out to you, I have it.
Oh, that's all right. I need to have it open in front of me. It'll be easier this way. All right. I already did the thing where I read to... I did a whole special episode just me reading the thing. There it is. Okay. Okay, so I need you to... All right, so you already did the roll to hit. So yep. You need 2d8 force damage for 1d4. So you roll 2d6.
Okay.
And what do you get?
That's 10.
10? All right, so you get to roll 20d8, and that's the damage you're going to do.
Okay. Hang on. For some reason, it's not working. Fine.
Here, I can do it on this one.
Okay, hang on. I think I got it.
Okay.
Uh, 98 damage.
Well, and then add your dex.
And then add your dex on top of that. 101.
Okay. All right, 101. Let me write that down. And now you also have to roll 10d4, and that's how much damage you take.
Okay. 23.
So you take 23 damage, but you, in doing so, you've dealt 101 damage. Oh, good lord. All right.
Castros, you might have to heal me. I'm not doing very good. Okay.
It's gonna be a while before it gets back around to him. Fortunately.
Yeah, I might die here. I'm pretty beat up.
Well, everybody's doing bad. I can do a mass healing.
Okay, well, I'm done with that. Ow, that hurt. But I'm gonna shoot him again because I got another attack. It won't be as powerful, but it'll be something.
Yeah, I don't think you want to use a soul arrow on that.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna
you
die.
Did. So just real quick, when you shot him with that, you shot into the middle of it, and it just recoils. It is just like you can see the pain just quiver through every tentacle as its whole body just convulses. You did so much damage. It did not expect that.
Yeah. And now I'm gonna hit him with like a regular arrow or something.
Alright.
That is a 23 to hit.
That hits.
Okay, let's see. What random arrow shall it be? Who knows? 29 or 37?
Let's watch this right, be the 29. Cannonball arrow then.
I know. I'm like, cannonball.
29 is the splitting arrow. Splits into three separate arrows mid-flight. Or 39 is Taser Bolt. Upon impact, target must make a constitution saving throw or be paralyzed.
I'm gonna get that one.
Alright, so constitution saving throw is 14 versus Alright, it's a tie, but I'm gonna give it to you. You paralyze it.
Cool, and that is, on top of that, another 11 damage.
11, all right. Just because, and the reason I'm giving it to you on that one is because, you know, normally the rules are that you, tie goes to the defender, but you hit it so hard on the previous shot that it lost because it was so constitutionally drained, if you will.
Yeah. Let's go.
All right, so noted. I will note here it is paralyzed. Okay. Jeez. All right, Alpha, your turn. You're in front of this paralyzed, damaged thing.
How heavily damaged does it look?
Oh, it looks hurt, but like, I mean, it obviously the arrow like blew a hole through it. Like, basically, it's a giant creature. Like, you shot it with a 12-gauge shotgun. You know, blew a hole in it, type of a thing.
Just debating whether or not to try Alpha's One Punch Man move.
One punch.
I guess you could.
Yeah, but it might be kind of overkill, though, is what I'm worried about. They could also leave him exhausted and prone to stuff.
And remember, we still got, what, 5 guards that we're having to deal with, too?
And it is paralyzed, so you have advantage.
Yeah. Alright, he's not gonna do that. He's just gonna punch.
I guess.
Just because I don't want to leave him open to potential issues. Alright, so we'll just continue his... Oh gosh, let me just do some math really quick.
Okay, 6. Okay. Paralyzes, creatures incapacitated, automatically saves strength and dex saves.
They have your creature tech. After the guards that are next to me.
I just have to think about like how much ki I have left, because I need to conserve some of that as well. So I'm just going to do 3. Not.
Oh. Well, like even with that. So I'm reading the condition thing for paralyzed. It says... Basically, because you're punching it, every hit is a critical hit.
Oh. All right. Well, then that's good that I'm only just going to use my 3 regular punches.
24. Yeah, each one of those 3 will do double damage.
And they all 3 hit. Fairly confident. Yeah. So, all right. So that is... 7, 12,
yeah,
6.
That was a heck of a shot, Ray.
That's 50 additional damage total.
All right, well, Alpha, you go up and you just bury your fists into it 3 times and it deflates.
Like he rips his hands through the open hole that starts pulling out intestines. Like,
it deflates down to the ground and it starts shrinking back down into a humanoid form that is face down currently. And I'm assuming that was all your attacks?
Yeah.
Your whole action? Alright, then it is the Pegasus!
How about this? I'll assign each of the creatures to defend a different person. So the Pegasus will defend Ray, since Ray is in the most dire straits. Pegasus will defend Ray, Giant Boar will defend Dane, and the Griffin will go to Alpha. Just to like give them like a little aid, each of them.
Right, you're gonna just direct them, alright. But does the Pegasus do anything once it flies over to where Ray is? There is a throne guard on the ground next to Ray and a guard right behind that guard.
Probably the guard that is standing.
Okay, so it's going to go fly over and, like, attack him?
Yeah, the Pegasus only has really one attack. Unfortunately.
Oh, hooves. I see that.
Alright, but it'll do it.
Okay.
It's a 24 to hit.
Oh, that hits.
And then 13 bludgeoning.
Jeez. Okay. I think that's this guard. All right. Oh, no, that's the wrong guard. Oh yeah, he takes a good hit. He's got the wind knocked out of him. It does not feel good for that guy. So this is the prone guard that Dane was wailing on. He's gonna first try to swing. Like he's whips around, tries to swing at disadvantage at Dane's ankle, and rolls a 17 to hit.
That does not hit. Barely.
All right. He doesn't know what to do, so he's just like flailing on the ground. He tries to swing again, and that's, oh God, 12 to hit.
No.
All right, he gives up on that and starts standing up. So he's okay. He's not going to do anything else there. And then it is back to... All right. The man that's laying on the ground in front of Alpha, you hear a just curse come out of his mouth as he starts to stand up. And what does he do? He has a complicated character sheet, so I have to think of what he would do in this situation. Oh, we're not going to do that, though. Ah, you see him disappear from before your eyes, Alpha. All of a sudden, vanish. We'll come back to him in a minute. Now, let's see. What guard was this? This must be the other guard that was next to Dane, so he's already up and on the... Oh, good lord. Yes. 13 to hit.
Nope.
And 22 to hit.
Yeah, that one will hit.
Alright, so he's going to hit you for 12 slashing. And he is going to... And then he'll try to hit you with his shield. That's the only thing he can do. Oh, wrong die. 21 to hit.
Yes, that hits.
Alright, then make your strength check.
That is a 23.
Oh yeah, you stand your ground and you're just like, nah, buddy, not happening.
Once was enough, right?
Yeah. Okay, so let's see. God, there's too many of them. I need you guys to start killing creatures.
We're trying.
Yeah.
I just made him disappear.
Well, good enough.
All right, so let's see. That was that one. Ah, the one that's prone next to Ray. He takes a swing at Ray's ankles to try to knock her down, and that is a 18 to hit.
Good lord, Ben.
That was with disadvantage.
How buffed are these guards?
They're not really that buffed. They're only... What is it? They're like challenge rating 5.
All right. Anyway,
I mean, that's pretty strong. Anyways, what's the damage?
11 slashing.
Oh God.
I'm sorry. I can't heal her. It's not my turn. As well as I'm in wild shape, I can't heal while in wild shape.
You might have to get out of wild shape.
Alright, and he takes a second slash, and that is 12.
That does not hit, which means I'm gonna redirect it at someone.
Okay.
Whatever guard is redirected, I don't care. No, actually, okay. Can I redirect it at one of the rats on me?
So you don't have a rat on you?
You don't have a rat on you, no.
One on Alpha.
Okay, then redirect it at the nearest guard.
Okay, wow, that's good, because he did 16 damage to that guard.
Let's go.
Alright, I think that's that guard. No, that's that guard. Okay, so... Oh, now it is the rats, and the first one... First of the rats, and it... I think that's this was the one that was on Kathros. Oh, he nat 20s. And that is...
I swear I'm going to steal your dice, Ben.
I know.
I give you mine.
That's
well, that's all right. It's only 7 piercing damage.
Well, you know, only 7 piercing damage.
Well, I mean, for a nat 20 on a rat, whatever. So the boar, it is the boar's turn. It goes running up to stand next to Dane.
Cool. It'll then... I'll actually do a charge attack.
Yeah, sure.
So yeah.
There's a guard right next to him. Yeah.
It's a tusk attack, but with extra add-ons.
Cool.
Oh, that's a nat 20.
Okay.
Of course, the giant boar gets a nat 20. You know.
Yeah, Alpha got one earlier. Didn't do that much, but still was a nat 20.
So compared to me, just like the of course the boar gets it. All right. Okay. So he takes 2d6, 3. So 6, 9, 9, and then takes an extra 2d6. So 9 plus 7. So it takes 16, and does that double with a nat 20?
It doesn't matter. You gore that guard and kill it.
This is the one next to Dane? One of the ones next to Dane? Okay.
Yes. So it's dead. Very much sincerely dead.
Cool.
Yep.
Not all for its turn.
Awesome. And then the second rat, which is up on Alpha. That is a... 22 to hit.
It ties with my AC. So.
All right, so it tries to bite you and fails.
Ha!
You knock it off. And,
imagine it's like going right, for then... Alpha's face, and Alpha just kind of ducks a little bit, and that goes flying by.
Awesome. Alright, so let's see. Which guard is this? This guard is the one that recently had the redirect attack, and he's like, damn it, you hit me! This hurts! I'm out of here! He's gonna flee.
Oh, attack of opportunity.
But you can do it.
Only the Pegasus could get an attack of opportunity at this point.
Can I have the Pegasus, like, back kick this guy as he passes?
Sure, roll the hit.
No, that was an 8.
Yeah, no. But he's severely injured. He's like, oi, I've got a family. I'm out of here.
I gotta make it a moral situation.
So he flees. He was very severely injured. I had a rule, once the guys got this injured, they'd be looking for an out. He got really bad. And it is the Griffin turn, and that is the one that you sent up to guard Alpha, so it's hanging out next to Alpha.
It's such a good guard, it couldn't even protect me from a rat.
It can attack the rat, I guess.
Sure, the griffin just chomps off the rat.
Sure. I mean, roll to hit. It's only a, it's a really low armor class.
12.
Ah! Tied with the rat.
Oh, God.
The rat runs away into Alpha's armpit.
Okay. Well, it has two attacks.
Okay.
So we can try again with a claw this time.
Alpha, hold very still.
Okay, that was a 17 hit.
Yeah, that hits.
Alright, you want me to roll damage?
I'll just give it to you. You killed the rat.
Cool. There you go. I rolled a 13 anyways.
Yeah, that would have killed it. But
there we go. Griffin just goes palms up to Alpha like, I did good, right?
Did good, kid. Did good.
Alright, Kasros, it's your turn.
Whoa. I guess So Ray really needs healing then.
I have 8 health points. Do with that what you wish.
Fine. Can you at least
Okay, fine. How many guards are there? And I have the Pegasus, right?
You've got
no.
One next to you.
I'll just cure one. It would be more troublesome if you were knocked unconscious. So I unwild shape, which should be a bonus action, run on over to Ray and use cure wounds.
Okay.
We'll put that in a... Just to make sure, that was a 19 to cast.
No, sure geez. That... Yeah. You're good.
Is that in a 4th level spell slot? Now I gotta do math.
It's all D&D is math.
Right.
And risk and imagination.
Okay, it's easy math. So that's...
There aren't any cops in the forest, but take this to them.
Oh, I rolled well on that. Okay. 48 ends up being 23. Plus spellcasting modifier. Adds up to 30-something. 31. And then the moonstone ends up doubling it, right?
Yep.
You get 62 back.
Cool.
There you go. Use that with what you will. You're welcome. This is why we need another healer, I swear to God. Or somebody who can make potions, anything. Jesus. Alright, that's my turn, though.
Awesome. Well, you saved Ray. And it's Dane.
Okay, so... Dane has one next to him, and there's still one next to Ray, right? Is that one next to Ray prone still?
Yeah, there's one next to Ray that's prone, one next to you that's not prone, and one next to Kasros that's not prone.
Okay, so first thing that Dane is going to do is he's going to cast Firebolt at the guard that is prone next to Ray.
Okay.
Ooh, very nice. That is a 27.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that hits. Jeez.
Yeah. I'm a better spellcaster than I am a melee fighter. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. That is 18 fire damage.
Jeez.
I want to give him something to think about other than attacking Ray.
Oh, he's thinking about you right now.
Fantastic. All right. And so then for my second attack, I'm going to take a swing at the guard in front of me. That is a 15 to hit.
That does not hit.
Yeah. My new axe is only +3 to hits. And then I'll try again for a 17 to hit.
That one hits.
All right. Ooh,
much better that time. That is 18 slashing damage.
Okay. Let's see. Yep, he is very dead.
Yay! I killed somebody.
Alright. And was that it for you? Is that your turn?
Yep, that was my turn. One, you know, fire damage and miss, and then another pretty good slashing attack.
Nice, yeah, that went well. So, let's see, this other guard is the one that's next to Kasros, who has D-Wild shaped, witnesses that, and then goes to strike as a result, and that is 22 to hit.
Hits.
And that is for 14 slashing. And then 18 to hit.
Yeah, that's...
Okay. Ooh, that is 16 slashing. And he's gonna try and bash you. Oh, that's a nat 20 on the bash.
Oh my goodness.
So let's do a... Yeah, I know. That was shocking. Five.
Not really the way you've been rolling tonight.
I've actually been not rolling... I mean, I've been rolling pretty balanced, I think. So that's 8 plus... Oh, yeah, ooh, dang. That's another 16 bludgeoning, and I need you to make a strength save.
Four.
Or, yeah, you are prone. He takes you down.
Cool. I'm at 6, by the way.
Oh, you're 6 on the ground.
We just did, what was that? It was 46 damage in one turn?
Yeah.
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 Jesus. From just level 5 creatures.
Alright, so that is, we're...
Wild shape at the... You don't understand how much... challenge rating 5 is.
Yeah. That is Ray's turn.
So did the wizard die or did he just disappear?
He disappeared.
Darn. I don't...
You're not sure what happened. He vanished from sight where he was at.
That means I don't get to reuse my hunter's mark. Anyways, I'm gonna shoot the guy that's on top of Kasros.
Thank you.
Oh, right on.
You'll get 21.
You'll get
21
hit.
21 is definitely a hit. Toastblends, and you have advantage on if the target. So, 7, mystically.
61.
I heard 61, so I'll look up that one first. That yep. is. Anti-ballistic arrow, a thick arrow that has a rounded tip with fletching that constantly adjusts and readjusts itself. Upon being fired, the arrow seeks out the closest moving projectile within 30 feet of the arrow's flight path. The arrow changes its direction to intercept the moving projectile and knocks it out of the air.
Don't want that one. What's 77?
77 is the Huntress Arrow. The goddess of the hunt blessed this arrow. Hits with the force of a falling oak tree.
That one!
Alright, I'm not sure what that is, but if you're shooting that guy that's prone on the ground, I'm just gonna say it's gonna kill him.
Shooting the guy who's on top of Kasros.
Oh, the guy that's on top of Kasros, yes. Cool. Well, let's... Let's see, what would a fall... dang it, I'm not sure how to calculate the impact of a falling oak tree. Let's call it...
That he's dead?
Well, I would say, you know, maybe roll 5d10.
5d10, I like that. Let's do 5d10.
Ready?
Twenty-four. Okay. So he gets hit and it hurts. He's not dead, but he is severely injured on the ground. And he's like, oh my god, I've been shot by an arrow before, but damn, that felt like an oak tree.
So does that mean he has no, like, he's in no danger of attacking Kasros next turn, or do I gotta
He could, technically, still.
Alrighty, I'm gonna shoot him in the head.
Okay.
That is a 30 to hit.
Oh, that definitely hits. Holy crap.
Yeah, I rolled a 19.
Damn.
Alrighty. That is either 74 or 70.
Okay, well, 70 is the grease arrow. Makes things slippery, and 74 is the trick strike arrow, which teleports mid-firing.
70. grease arrow.
Oh, no, it doesn't teleport you. It's just the arrow teleports. Like, you fire, it disappears from your bow and reappears, like, at his head and then hits him.
Okay, then I guess that one's fine. Either one works.
Okay. We'll just say it lodges in and, let's just say it kills him.
Cool. Alright, that's my turn.
Awesome. Alright, well, that guy is deceased. Let me eliminate him from my list. Good lord. Alpha, you're standing up there at the gate. There is a griffin next to you. The rest of the party is down below, and you're not sure what exactly what happened. You just saw this guy blink out of existence.
Well, what's left to eliminate?
There is a guard down next to Ray and a rat on Kasros.
And there's a guard next to me still.
I swear to God, the rat bites me and I die, I'm gonna be really upset.
The only guard I think I have left is the one that's prone on the ground next to Ray.
Oh.
Well, I had by me. One got smashed by the boar, and then the other one's the one I hit last turn.
Oh, well. All I've got on my map is that one that's next to Ray, so I must have missed one somewhere.
Or maybe I did.
Yeah, I think
18 slashing damage.
Let's just go with you.
I think you probably killed him.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, because you were saying you finally killed something.
Oh, yeah.
Let's just go with you killed him. This is a loose end. I'll get tied up later. He comes back like, you killed my brother and prepare to die.
My name is Inigo Montoya. You killed my father. Prepare to die.
Basically, yes.
All right, so that's what you got, Alpha. There's a guy down prone on the ground. You want to go, like, punch his face in?
All right, well, we're just going to go ahead and, I'll get the big baddie first, like the actual guard.
What about the rat?
No, the griffin took care of the rat.
No,
there's another rat.
Die if that rat bites him. Yeah.
I'm more concerned about the big guards. Alpha doesn't put much stock in rats. It's a 22 to hit.
Oh yeah, that hits.
So yeah. That goes to... eight damage. Is he still standing?
No, he's already... Well, he was on the ground. You just went up and punched him in the face and killed him.
Right. And I guess since they're all kind of within range and I can just keep attacking, I have two more attacks, so punch a rat.
Yay.
19 to hit.
That hits.
All right. You need damage for
the
rat?
I think we can just say you killed it. No, you killed it.
All right, and the third one is a 20 to hit for the last rat.
No, the rats are all dead.
Okay, I thought there were two more rats.
No, there were only two rats, big ones that marked you guys out, and the griffin killed the one on you, and you killed the one on Kasros, and now everything that attacked you is dead, and The only thing that's left on the field that's not your party is the three creatures that Castros had summoned.
All right, so we're good.
Does the Pegasus have healing capabilities? Let's find out one second.
I don't think so.
I was joking, but no, it does not.
Actually, I wonder. There might be a... No, I don't see anything. I was going to see if someone wrote, like, a homebrew where you could, like, use Pegasus blood or something. But I don't see anything.
Maybe. You wouldn't kill it, just suck on its neck for a while.
We harvest the Pegasus for its healing properties.
Alright. Well, you guys survive, and you're standing there. There's bodies around you. I guess technically that Pass Without a Trace is still functional.
Yep.
So you're... Now that the markers are... Good. You what?
Can I touch myself really quick before I die?
Of course.
Oh, God.
There's always time to touch yourself.
I hate you all.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to also go on the fourth level spell slot because I'm not using it for anything. That's four. To make sure it doesn't...
Anybody else.
As a 10 to cast.
Well, you're healing yourself. You're your own willing creature, so I think you're fine.
Maybe. You never know. Brain...
You're unwillingly healing yourself?
Well,
I wanted to die on the battlefield.
Castros is in a lot of pain. He might be a little distracted.
True. 19 plus 8.
I really did not expect you guys to do that.
27.
Well, we did.
Okay, I get back 54. So I'm back at 60, which isn't great, but I'll take it for now. Alright, cool. Just so that I don't accidentally stub a toe and die immediately.
Probably a good idea.
Yeah. Alright. I swear, we need to carry potions, like... Or one of you learn a healing spell. I know Dane can't.
Yeah.
I can learn Goodberry, but that's about it.
I'm the wrong school of monk.
Yeah. Kind of funny, wizards aren't all that concerned with healing other people, apparently.
No, not really. I swear, next campaign I do, I'm just going to be full-on healer. I'm not going to bother helping with combat, because it's always the healer that gets needed.
Hey, Ron was actually still fun, and he was the main healer.
That's true.
Well, the next campaign we do, I'm going to be a paladin, so it'll all work out.
Anyways.
Party of all healers. I love it.
We should. It's just like somebody punches us, we just go, oh, and we're all healed up again.
All right, you guys are here. What do you want to do?
I don't know. The thing is, you know...
The guy we were trying to fight is gone, so what now?
I mean, normally I would say, you know, we just kind of make our way up into the palace and continue our search for the wizard, but we're all pretty banged up, and the whole city is looking for us.
Yeah, this wasn't really our best.
How close are the catacombs?
If you ran through into the gate, probably relatively close. Like, if you bolted for it, you could easily make it there.
Yeah, so while Pass Without a Trace is working, let's head into the catacombs and just kind of
find a place to up in the upper levels there to hole up and rest.
Sounds good to me.
Okay, well, I think that's what we'll do then.
All right, so you guys bolt for it.
Yeah.
And just for fun, I want to check something. No! Oh, wow. You made it.
Oh, yay.
I had to do two checks, and you guys passed both of them. So.
Well, right. Fantastic.
Yeah, well, I rolled a 7 and a 3. That's pretty good. So you make it. You know where the catacombs are. You know how to get down there. They're, you know, old hat to you now, so you can disappear into them. And of course, no one would think to look for you there.
Well, you still have the regular patrols down there, but yeah.
Why would these?
Yeah, not really though. Compared to everywhere
into
else.
The danger, that makes no sense.
Yeah.
Now, directly into the danger would be running into the palace when you got everybody and everything looking for us. The catacombs is kind of a 180. And we're not going down deep where all the real danger is. We're just kind of staying at the, you know, top level of the catacombs.
Makes sense to me. All right. Well, I suppose you guys, you know your way around. You find yourself a nice spot, and I'm assuming you're just gonna hold up, like do a nice long rest, lick your wounds, all that.
Yep, I think that's the smart thing to do.
All right.
Cool.
Well, I guess in that case we stop there. You guys sleeping in the catacombs, hiding away from the guards that are searching for you, and whatever all happened with that crazy guy that disappeared.
Good about how today went.
Well, we'll definitely, as soon as we heal up, we'll go looking for him.
Alright. Tune in next week.
We'll just barely have it so my hunter's mark isn't effective anymore. It's so much easier, but not powerful enough.
I know, but
does it normally let you track him, or?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, I can track him pretty easily. It gives me a plus on perception checks when trying to find it.
Gotcha.
Yeah, but it'll end by the end of our long rest. So
yeah. Well, yeah, and you didn't do any of those checks. You were too busy doing other stuff.
Yeah, like trying to survive.
Yeah.
Well, I murdered some people. Had a fun time. It's good. It's all good.
I mean, that was probably one of the longest battles we've had in a very long time.
Yeah. It you guys had me have more tabs open than I've ever had open. Just trying to keep track of that.
I didn't even do anything. 15.
It's 17 tabs open, just to track all that.
That's a lot of tabs.
Yeah.
That's one way to keep tabs. Now, the problem is,
you rolled almost as bad as I did, so...
I just had to keep looking up everything, because I was like, geez, there's too much. Can't believe that shot with the freaking arrow. Holy crap.
Let's go.
Well, we needed something.
And then immediately after, I was like, okay, that was cool. Ow!
Yeah, I didn't realize that her soul arrow worked the same way as Dane's axe, so...
Yeah.
We'll definitely... use that as kind of a last resort type thing from now on.
Well... That battle would have gone a lot differently had that choice not been made. I mean, that was impressive.
You're saying the battle would have probably gone worse, huh?
Oh, yeah, very likely.
Well, good thing we used it then. Well, I mean, we still could have used Dane's, could have used his soul axe. That's always in reserve as well.
Yeah, well, yeah, you could always.
It doesn't really clearly explain the exhaustion mechanic for Alpha if he goes through that buff. Does it like get negative on everything after?
It's part of the core rules.
Ah.
It's, yeah, it's nothing I wrote up. Okay, here, let me do. Bring up conditions really quick. It'll just take me a second. I've got it here. Oh, exhaustion. Here it is. Level 1 is disadvantage on ability checks. Level 2 is speed is halved. Level 3, disadvantage on attack rolls and saving throws. Level 4, hit point maximum is halved. Level 5, speed reduced to 0. And level 6 is death.
Oh. Yeah, that could be bad.
Yeah, so don't get yourself all the way to a 6. It's not really possible the way it's written up to get to that easily. Like, usually you'd get to the point where you'd just, like, over 2 days, you could easily expend yourself down to where you're reduced to 0. Like, getting the 5 levels of exhaustion, I could see you pulling off, but 6 would be difficult.
I'll try to avoid.
This has been an Azentuary LLC production. Find us online at azentuary.com for character bios, merchandise, Patreon, and more. Thank you for listening.
Hang on. Give me 1 second. Hang on, I gotta look at something.